So alhamdulillah, last week we started with the fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, brothers and sisters in Islam, in continuation and resumption of our weekly tafsir of Al-Quran al-Kareem. Alhamdulillah, in our last lesson, we had completed ayah number 90 of Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 90 of Surah Al-Baqarah. Inshallah, we will just recite it as we usually recite our ayat collectively together, inshallah, so that we may complete our Khatm Al-Quran in this fashion as we proceed and go along. So everyone will say together, inshallah, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Together, inshallah. وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ. Sorry, ayah number 89. Because last week we didn't recite. So let me just go back to that, inshallah, again. Ayah number 89. طيب. Bismillah. Together, inshallah. وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ كِتَابٌ مِّنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَهُمْ وَكَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ يَسْتَفْتِحُونَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ مَا عَرَفُوا كَفَرُوا بِهِ فَلَعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ بِئْسَ مَا اشْتَرَوْا بِهِ أَنفُسَهُمْ أَنْ يَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ بغيا أن ينزل الله من فضله على من يشاء من عباده فباءوا بغضب على غضب وللكافرين عذاب مهين وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا بما أنزل الله قالوا نؤمن بما أنزل علينا ويكفرون بما وراءه وهو الحق مصدقا لما معهم قل فلم تقتلون أنبياء الله من قبل إن كنتم مؤمنين ولقد جاءكم موسى بالبينات ثم اتخذتم العجل من بعده وأنتم ظالمون وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورَ خُذُوا مَا آتَيْنَاكُمْ بِقُوَّةٍ وَاسْمَعُوا قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ قُلْ بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ صدق الله العظيم. نعم. Actually, we have completed up to ayah number 91, but we'll just go through the ayah again, inshallah, that verse again. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ قَالُوا نُؤْمِنُوا. And when it is said to them, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ, and when it is said to them, القول, this is فعل مجهول, يعني. This is a passive form of the tense, of the word format. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا, believe, آمِنُوا, bring iman in that which Allah had revealed, that which Allah has revealed, قَالُوا, they say. So this is in Arabic would be شرط and جزاء, the cause and the outcome, or the condition and the outcome. قَالُوا, they say in reply, نُؤْمِنُ بِمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا, we believe in that which was revealed upon us. The Torah and the Injil, Old Testament, New Testament. وَيَكْفُرُونَ بِمَا وَرَاءَهُ, and they deny and they disbelieve in that which came afterwards. That which came afterwards, يعني القرآن الكريم, يعني القرآن الكريم. And everything stems out, everything stems from their hasad, their jealousy, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not from Bani Israel, but from Bani Ismail. Nabi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not from their kind or not from their lineage of the Israelites, but Rasulullah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the Bani Ismail, from the Arab descendants. And this was the chief and the main cause of the hasad, that the jealousy towards the Arabs and towards Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, despite their knowledge and everything, kama marra, as we have completed earlier on. So they had 100% knowledge and recognition of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They understood everything, they knew everything. Allah said, لا تكونوا أول كافرين بي, don't be of the first disbelievers amongst people, understand? At least amongst the Bani Israel also. But they chose otherwise. وهو الحق مصدقا لما معهم. And whereas, although it is the truth, confirming, مصدقا لما معهم, confirming what is in their own scriptures. مصدقا, making تصديق, يعني verifying, confirming that which they already have. لما معهم, that which is in front of them, that which they have. Okay, subhanallah. And what do they have? At-Tawrat wal-Injil wal-Zabur wa ghayri dhalik. They have the Old Testament and the New Testament and the scriptures previous as well. قُلْ فَلِمَ تَقْتُلُونَ أَنْبِيَاءَ اللَّهِ مِنْ قَبْلُ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Say to them, why then did you kill Allah's prophets before if you are truly believers? And if you really have, as you say, the seed of Iman and you believe in that which is with you, then why did you kill the prophets before you? Before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You understand? Which is a well-known fact amongst Bani Israel. Either fariqan taqtuluna, they would kill some, and wa fariqan, they would disbelieve in some anbiya, and they would kill the other anbiya, subhanallah. فَفَرِيقًا كَذَّبَتُمْ وَفَرِيقًا تَقْتُلُونَ. Some anbiya and rusul, they would either reject, and some they would attempt to assassinate, and some they have killed an assassination. Even the Prophet ﷺ himself, they attempted his assassination and they attempted to kill him. Subhanallah. Allah says, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ. Those who were given the kitab, they fully recognize Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just as they know their own children. Subhanallah. Just as they know their own children. In fact, بَلْ أَشَدْ. In fact, more than they know their own children, they know Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Naam, because who told them that the child is their child? Their wife told them. What if the wife was messing around, sleeping around? The husband will not know that. So he just takes it on face value. He believes her word that the child is his child. Okay? Subhanallah. أفكلما إذا الله says in another place, أفكلما جاءكم رسول بما لا تهوى أنفسكم استكبرتم ففريقا كذبتم وفريقا تقتلون, as we just shared with you just now. So if you really have, as you claim, the seed of Iman, okay, fine. Let's just hypothetically say to you that we go with what you say, that you will only believe in that which came before and that which you have in front of you, not what's afterwards, that is the Quran. Then why did you kill the Anbiya? Why did you reject the other Anbiya? And they were all from your kind. Subhanallah. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. Indeed, جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى. Moses came to you, Musa came to you and brought to you clear proofs, clear evidence, clear signs, يعني clear miracles. The miracles of Musa was not unknown. They know all of the miracles. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانِ. We sent to them the floods, والجراد, and the locusts, والقمل, and the lice, والضفادع, and the frogs, والدم, and the blood, آيات مفصلات, all the different signs. That was even prior to the exodus that took place. That was even prior to the exodus that took place, and that is the salvation of Musa alayhi salam and his people from the tyranny of Fir'aun. All of that ayat, and by that, those ayat already were there in the age and the era of the period of Egypt, while they were in Egypt under the tyranny of Fir'aun, subhanallah. So they seen with their own eyes all these miracles taking place, all these signs taking place, all these proofs taking place. There was no iota of doubt in the message of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. There was no iota of doubt. So they have no reason to disbelieve in Musa alayhi salam and the teachings of Musa alayhi salam. Similarly, part of their teachings is the coming of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have no reason, they have no grounds to disbelieve in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Musa brought to you the clear signs, the clear proofs, understand? Amongst the other signs was, for example, the water from the stone and the splitting of the ocean which they seen. So perhaps you could say, okay, never mind, that was just a pandemic that took place. The lice and the frogs and the this and that, whatever else. But the splitting of the ocean, which power on earth can do that? No power on earth can do that. Subhanallah. This was right in front of you. And you crossed the Red Sea. And Allah drowned Fir'aun and his people in the Red Sea. And you saw his dead body. And you saw the fact that the earth is not accepting his body. And the ocean is not accepting his body. Subhanallah. You've seen all of that. Ayatim mubayyinat. Clear signs. ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. الله أكبر. But still day after, you worship the calf in his absence, acting wrongfully. ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ. Musa a.s. went on a noble mission, taking 70 of his people to go and receive the Torah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, come back with bisharat and glad tidings and, you know, goodness to his people, and yet to find that half of the community has disbelieved and they worship in the calf. Subhanallah. Not only that, the love of that calf, the love of the cow has entered the depths of their souls. That even till today, you're on the tongue, there's holy cow, holy cow. Even when they are swearing and when they are a bit loose on their tongues, holy cow, holy cow. Where did that come from? If they had not, وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجَلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ. Right here in front of us. And in their hearts, وَأُشْرِبُوا, the love of the calf was rooted in their hearts. Rooted in their hearts. Yani, can you imagine that a nation that has seen multiple miracles, multiple signs, and Allah Ta'ala live has removed them from the tyranny of Fir'aun, not in the fashion of the way of the Sahaba, where they had to flee Makkah Mukarramah, and then they had to establish a base, and they went through the normal process of any other community would go through, and they would strengthen themselves, and galvanize and bolster and come into war and fight for their rights and then gain their victory. You know, no, this was direct. They were under the tyranny of Musa. Miraculously, they were saved from Fir'aun. Subhanallah. Despite this year, we know the condition. But still, indeed, day after you took to the worship of the calf in the absence of Musa al-Islam, antum zalimun, whereas you were the zalim, you were the oppressors and the wrongdoers. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَكُمْ وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورِ. And when we took your covenant and raised the mountain above you. We raised the mountain above you. So the Torah came to them. The Torah came to them and the incident of the worship of the calf, obviously that is وَرَفَعْنَا فَوْقَكُمُ الطُّورِ. Allah Ta'ala raised up the Mount Tur above their heads. Will you believe? Will you believe? Will you believe? Subhanallah. How wretched has to a nation have to be for them to reach a point where Allah, their creator, is raising up the mountain above their heads and threatening to kill them and crush them with the mountain. Subhanallah. This is not their contemporary or the adversary of human being and humankind. This is a mountain which Allah is raised above their heads and threatening to crush them. But so how wretched a nation has to reach that this is the condition. So when we see that a janazah is in process and the bier of the janazah is being carried, and you see that the army is coming and attacking the mourners and attacking the people who are carrying the janazah, it's not difficult for us to understand that if this is the history, that's nothing. If this is the history, then that is nothing, because they are the same children of these people here. Subhanallah. قالوا ليس علينا في الأميين السبيل. They said, these ummis, these illiterate people, unlettered people, they know nothing, they're ignorant. They have no recourse against us. They have no, ليس علينا في الأميين السبيل. They got no sabil on us. So when we see these types of actions, it's not difficult for us to believe. It's not difficult for us to believe that this, something like this can take place and can happen. Subhanallah. وإذا أخذنا ميثاقكم ورفعنا فوقكم الطور خذوا ما آتيناكم بقوة واسمعوا. Hold firmly to it. That is the scripture. ما آتيناكم. That which we have given you. خذوا. Hold. Take. ما آتيناكم. That which we have given you. بقوة. Firmly. Like Allah, Allah, like Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us. عليكم بسنتي. Hold my sunnah. And the sunnah of my khulafa. الراشدين. عضوا عليها بالنواجذ. Bite onto it. Hold onto it firmly with your molars. Don't let go of the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Subhanallah. واسمعوا. And listen. And listen, and listen. Hold firmly to this, to that scripture which you were given to, and obey. وَاسْمَعُوا وَأَطِيعُوا يعني and obey. قَالُوا قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا. They said, we hear and disobey. We hear and disobey. Subhanallah. And the mountain is above the heads. Allahu Akbar. The love وَأُشْرِبُوا فِي قُلُوبِهِمُ الْعِجْلَ بِكُفْرِهِمْ. The love of the calf was rooted in their hearts. The love of the calf was rooted in their hearts. Subhanallah. قُلْ بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Say to them, بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ. How evil is what your so-called belief. بِئْسَ مَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِهِ إِيمَانُكُمْ. إِيمَانُكُمْ, your iman is the doer. How evil is your iman that it is commanding you to that which is evil, prompts you to that which is evil. How evil is what your so-called belief prompts you towards. What's that? Towards disbelieving, towards killing the Anbiya, towards rejecting the prophethood of the Anbiya, etc. What kind of iman you have? If you claim iman, what kind of iman you have? That your iman is prompting you to this type of actions. In kuntum mu'mineen, if you actually believe in the Torah, if you actually believe in the Torah and that which is in front of you.
قُلْ إِنْ كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوا.
Let us recite this together, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Together, inshallah.
قُلْ إِنْ كَانَتْ لَكُمُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَالِصَةً مِّن دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوُا الْمَوْتَ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ ولتجدنهم أحرص الناس على حياة ومن الذين أشركوا يود أحدهم لو يعمر ألف سنة وما هو بمزحزحه من العذاب أن يعمر والله بصير بما يعملون.
نعم. قل. Say to them, O Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن كانت لكم الدار الآخرة عند الله خالصة من دون الناس. سبحان الله. They may this is now okay. Let's look at translation first. Say to them, O Prophet, if the eternal home of the year after, إن كانت دار الآخرة, if the دار الآخرة is yours exclusively, بني إسرائيل is yours. لكم إن كانت لكم الدار الآخرة. If the آخرة is for you from Allah خالصة exclusively من دون الناس by removing other people and nobody is حق دار, nobody is worthy and deserving of that دار الآخرة, then let's see if you're true to your statement. فتمنوا الموت. Then out of all humanity wish for death if what you say is true. فتمنوا الموت إن كنتم صادقين. If you are truthful in your claim, you say that the Darul Akhirah, the ultimate abode in heaven, is for you only, exclusively, and nobody else is deserving of that, then come, be true to your claim, be true to your word, and you desire and wish and pray for death. Yani, it's almost like a curse. Curse yourself to die immediately. You understand? If you are true to your claim. وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوهُ أَبَدًا وَلَنْ يَتَمَنَّوهُ أَبَدًا بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. And they will never wish for that بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ, because of what their hands have done. يعني not what they have done بما كسبت أيديهم. Now the translation doesn't make doesn't do justice. بما قدمت أيديهم, what their hands have sent forward, what they have hands, their hands, their actions have already have been documented and recorded. يعني what you have done, you've already sent it forward to your آخرة, and it's waiting for you. If it's goodness or it's شر, خير أو شر. فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره, ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. Who does an iota of good will see it, who does as an iota of bad will see that. So your hands have already sent it forward, your actions have sent it forward. So you know what you have done, what you have done. First of all, you criticize Musa alayhi salam in the days of Egypt. Okay, he said, since you came Musa, we had more problems with Fir'aun. Because of you, I in problems. That's what they said, Musa alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam is trying to help them. He says, because of you, I in problems with Fir'aun. Never mind. Musa alayhi salam takes them to the ocean. As they standing in front of the ocean, he said, look, now you brought us to our certain death. Never mind. They crossed the ocean. Allah saved them from Fir'aun. No? They passed by a nation who's worshipping the calf. They said, make for us a creator like this guy, like these people have created. Shaykh, Allah took you out of the tyranny of Fir'aun. Allah allowed you to cross the ocean miraculously. And you're asking for a god? You're asking for a deity? We can just go on and on and on, naming and naming and naming. SubhanAllah. So this is what all of the actions they have, hands have sent forward. مَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. So they will never desire death. They will never wish for death because they know what is waiting for them, what they have done, what they have. وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ. And Allah Ta'ala knows of the ظَالِمِينَ. Allah Ta'ala knows and has perfect knowledge of the wrongdoers. So this ayah is one of the ayat of mubahala. Mubahala. This is called the concept of mubahala, and that is the concept of bringing on a curse. Bringing on, yani asking for you for the punishment to be brought upon you based on your claim. Based on your claim. So for example, another example is in the Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ حَاجَّكَ فِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا. When the Wafdu Najran, when the Wafdu Najran came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, discussions took place and etc. etc. And then they didn't want eventually they didn't want to believe. So what did Allah reveal? Allah said, فَمَنْ حَاجَّكَ فِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ فَقُلْ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ فَقُلْ. And say to them, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after they have arguing with you, etc. تعالوا, come, no problem. نَدْعُوا أَبَنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ. We will call our immediate families, the closest to us, yani. I will call my children, Hassan, Hussein, I'll call Fatima, I'll call Ali, I'll call my household, and then أَبْنَاءَنَا. And you call your households, call your immediate families, because these are the closest to us. We will do anything for their protection. We'll do anything for their protection. وَنِسَاءَنَا وَنِسَاءَكُمْ. Let's call our wives, you call your wives also. And let's all stand in front on either side, on either side. And now we start. وَأَنفُسَنَا وَأَنفُسَكُمْ. You must be present yourself as well. I'll be here, you'll be here as well. Okay? Now we say, ثُمَّ نَبَتَهِلْ. And then we hurl curses against each other and ask Allah to bring down the punishment from Allah. Say, Allah, we hurl the curses towards each other and ask Allah tell us, فَنَجْعَلْ لَعْنَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَى الْكَاذِبِينَ. And Allah Ta'ala, you bring your la'nat and your curse and your punishment on the kadibin, on the liars between us. SubhanAllah. They almost were about to do that. They almost were about to do that. The challenge with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Challenge of mubahala. And then one of the elders said, hey, you guys crazy, Shaykh. Are you mad? If he has to say one curse against you, your progenies will be destroyed forever until Qiyamah. Because they knew the haqq. They knew that. Immediately they refused and they turned away. Then Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam subjugated them, and then they started paying the jizya and the tax, etc., etc. And then they were subservient. Otherwise, they were not. SubhanAllah. And Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sent with them Abu Ubaidah bin al-Jarrah, etc., as a mediator amongst them. SubhanAllah. So that incident will come on that place. So this concept is known as the concept of mubahala. In this occasion, although the word of mubahala is not being used like in Al Imran, ثُمَّ نَبَتَّهِلْ, on this occasion the verb of tamanni is being used, yani hoping and wishing. فَتَمَنَّوُ الْمَوْتِ, yani desire for death, yani ask Allah, if I am true, yani if the akhirat is mine exclusively, then Allah should take you immediately. What are you wasting time here? Shaykh, let us live here because the akhirat is for you. Let us live here and enjoy this life without you, okay? You can go for the akhirah, no problem, Shaykh.
then desire death.
Allahu Akbar.
يعني قال الضحاك عن ابن عباس, ابن عباس رضي الله عنه سيد فتمنوا يعني فسلوا الموت. Ask Allah for death. قال ابن عباس لو تمنى يهود الموت, if the Yahud had to make tamanna of موت, desire موت, لما تو, they would have died immediately. They would have died. سبحان الله. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, if they had desired death, they would have choked on their own saliva and died immediately. They would have choked on their own saliva and died immediately. Subhanallah. ولو يعني سبحان الله. قال ابن جرير في تفسيره بلغنا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لو أن اليهود تمنوا الموت لماتوا. They would have died if they had desired this year. ولا رأوا مقاعدهم من النار, and they would have seen the abodes in the fire. ولو خرج الذين يباهلون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لرجعوا لا يجدون أهلا ولا مالا. And if those people, the Wafd Najran, had to come out to challenge Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم in the occasions of Mubahala, they would have returned to their places and they would have not find any family left, any wealth left, nothing would be left. Subhanallah. In fact, somehow they said to one another, والله لئن باهلتم هذا النبي, if you had to make مباهلة with this نبي, لا يبقى منكم عين تطرف, there will not be one eye amongst us left that will be even blinking an eye. Subhanallah. Our entire progenies would have been dead. Our entire progenies would have been destroyed immediately. Subhanallah. And what did they say? What did they say? وقالت اليهود والنصارى نحن أبناء الله وأحباؤه. They said we are the sons of God and we are the beloveds of God. Subhanallah. That's what they continue said. They said, لن يدخل الجنة إلا من كان هودا أو نصارى. No one will enter Jannah except that person who is Yahudi or Nasrani. See, they're all the claims and all recorded in the Kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, never mind, come and they desire death. Subhanallah. Then the next ayah. قل إن كانت لكم الدار الآخرة عند الله وَلَتَجِدَنَّهُمْ أَحْرَصَ النَّاسِ عَلَى حَيَاةٍ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. And you will surely, most certainly, there is ta'kid and emphasis in this word, find them أحْرَصَ النَّاسِ. أَحْرَصَ النَّاسِ comes from the superlative in Arabic. Ismu al-tafdil. Ismu al-tafdil, many of you have done ismu al-tafdil. The superlative. The most greedy, حَرِيص, من الحِرص. The most greedy, the most desirous. How are you translating it? You will find them clinging to life. Yani most greedy and desirous of life. Hayat. They want to live forever and forever. وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. And the more and even more than the polytheists. Subhanallah. The polytheists already desire to live forever. And desire thousands of years. The Yahud desire even more than that. Even more than that. Subhanallah. In fact, Allah says, يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ, each one of them wishes to live, لَوْ يُعَمَّرْ, if only we were given life, أَلْفَ سَنَةً, for 1,000 years. يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ يُعَمَّرُ, أَلْفَ سَنَةً, for 1,000 years. وَمَا هُوَ بِمُزَحْزِحِهِ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ أَنْ يُعَمَّرْ. The fact that he will be given long life, أَنْ يُعَمَّرْ, this is the fa'il, the doer in this case here. This will not save them. But even if they were to live that long, the fact that they were given so long life would not save them from the punishment of the adab, from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu basirun bima ya'malun. And Allah ta'ala is all seeing of what they are doing. So this is the hirs and the desire for tulul umr, for an extended life of thousands and thousands and thousands of years. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. In fact, in Surah Al-Jum'ah, Allah says, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ هَادُوا, أو يهود, أو people of يهود, إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ لِلَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ النَّاسِ. If you claim that you are the awliya, the friends of Allah, besides mankind, فَتَمَنَّوا مَوْتًا كُنُوا صَدِقِينَ, then desire death if you are truthful. So this is another ayah in the same ma'ana, in the same meaning. وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا. Allah says here, Allah uses one word to refer to the same meaning. They will never desire death by using وَلَيَّتَمَنَّا. And then Allah says, وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا. they will not desire it forever. And he never desired bima qaddamat aydihim, because of what their hands have already sent forward. So you know, if they die now, Shaykh, we have to give accountability for our actions. And what is waiting for us there is not looking very good for us. Wallahu alimun bil-zalimeen. And Allah Ta'ala knows, is all-knowing of the oppressors. And then Allah says there in Surah Jum'ah, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ, that say to them, that death which you are running away from, مِنُهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, it is coming to catch you. It is coming to meet you. You're running away from death and you're making these big qil'a and big fortresses and big presidential homes, big this and that. فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, it is coming to get you. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَلِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ, and then you will be returned back to the knowledge, the knower of ghaib and shahada. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and he will inform you of that which you have been doing. Subhanallah. One of our brothers not too long ago, his sister passed away. Subhanallah. About maybe 2 months ago or something like that. And he was telling me that they had just built their home in Pakistan, and they were just there for just almost like maybe a year. Brand new house and everything. Subhanallah. Maybe a year, just a year and a half. Now, there's no makin, there's nobody to live in the house. Subhanallah. Beautiful. Ali Shan, yani, massive home, everything is there, everything found for. That's why Nabi Sassam said, لا تتخذوا الضيعة. Don't take too much to properties and all of these things. ترغبوا في الدنيا. Your heart will become shackled to this dunya. Your heart will become attached to this dunya. You can't move. And you're stuck. And I said, Subhanallah. So let us be careful of that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah Ta'ala mentions all of these things so that we do not make the same mistakes. May Allah Ta'ala subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, inshallah. Inshallah, wa ila hahuna natawakaf, inshallah. Thumma nastamir fi al-usbu' al-qadim. We'll continue next week, inshallah. If Allah Ta'ala gives us tawfiq. Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, wa bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka, wa natubu ilayk. Wa sallallahu ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rahmatika ya rabbal alamin. And that's